Otto just walked in. Hi,
hey,
buddy.
Hey, Otto.
We're watching a clip on The View where Bill Maher made a joke about Elizabeth Hasselbeck and she's annoyed. But fucking Joy Behar always sticks up for comedians because she's a real stand-up.
But, yeah. I mean, she's Love annoyed Joy because Behar. The joke was about her. But her mistake is basically saying that it's not funny and no one should think this is funny. Instead of saying it wasn't funny to me.
If I was at home and this show was on TV and I couldn't find a clicker and it was a handgun on the coffee table, I'd fucking use that on myself rather than watch this show. Are you kidding me?
It was a handgun
this is what you're
on the
fucking
table?
Doing when Anthony's not here? He's just showing this
really?
Shit.
Really? That's funny, Otto.
All right. I'm sorry.
It's a viral clip, all right?
I was just kidding.
Don't be so sensitive, man. I just had a rough experience getting up here, man.
What happened to you?
Just trying to swipe that fucking subway thing, man. It says unacceptable, see attendant. And it was like 18 people in line to see this fucking silverback in the fucking booth there. You know, and then I had to go re-fucking charge I'm just not used to this happy commute that everybody goes about their day doing their little swipes and get, you know, it just rejected me. It sensed the nervousness or something. Yeah, it's just fucking horrible.
Did you wipe it on your pants?
No, it's
sometimes
a good
that
card.
Works.
It's got $20 on it. It's just fucking horrible getting up here. I mean, just really appreciate being a comic that I don't have to go on with this commute every day.
Right.
It's horrible.
I think that whenever I'm in traffic, it's like, how do people do this 5 days a week?
Yeah.
Fucking, I don't know how they do it. Is how do you not just snap and murder people on the highway?
Yeah, the Colin Ferguson guy. There should be 10 of those a day. You know, I don't understand how people don't just freak out. They're miserable lives, ineffectual, dumb lives.
Tell us how you really feel.
Yeah,
fucking Chip. Let's hear what Bill Maher said.
Okay. And I like George Graham.
Would you say that again, knowing what you know?
What you have to know is that somebody has to be out on the edge to know where the edge is.
Oh, thanks for being the hero, I guess, but I'm just saying, would you
pause
say...
That right there?
I just wanted to say pause that. Go ahead.
Yeah. Sort of question. Would you say that again?
Would you use
that same trade of women, say, if you're so supportive of women...
If I had a crystal ball and knew I was coming here and had to, like, spend my whole segment talking about it, no, I wouldn't.
No, you don't.
Really wouldn't be worth
it. Listen,
but,
I went through years...
But, you know, worse things have happened to people.
I went through years of bah-wah-wah-wah. I survived. And, right.
My feelings weren't hurt. I'm speaking on behalf of women.
What,
we don't treat
what a fucking
Thank you.
Fucking passive aggressive. Phony bitch.
She was completely bothered.
Yes, and none of the women there are defending her.
Right.
None of them. Nobody. They never defend this psycho. She's a passive aggressive fucking lunatic.
But that's why she's on the show.
And the only reason why she's on the show is because she's got a pretty face. Man. What fucking talent does she have?
And they sort of try to balance it out.
But what talent did she have to get the job?
A pretty face.
No, that's it.
She ate bugs on Survivor. That's how we all got to know her.
The only reason you're here is because you're fucking pretty. You elitist, never been told to shut the fuck up twat.
But no. To break it down, it's fine if she's bothered by the joke.
That's why I love fat chicks. They're happy and they have low self-esteem.
The whole world knows that.
Nice people.
The whole world knows she was bothered by the joke and she's going to go on her own fucking show with these hens and say she wasn't bothered? That's bullshit.
Yeah, she's bothered.
But just come on.
If she went out, you know what? You really offended me with what you said.
Right.
That hurt my feelings and I didn't like being... He would have went, hey, I'm sorry, I fucked up.
Right.
But the passive-aggressive way she's doing this is fucking... Just it angers me so bad. I fucking hate passive-aggressive people.
That's why she's there. She's her role, and this is where kind of like they give conservative women
What's
a hard
role?
Time to be the dumb conservative lady.
I thought you said
she's
roles.
Hot.
I was looking for roles,
but I got it.
I'm hungry.
I know.
I have roles. I'll keep going.
I think that was good. But that's why she's there. She's the dumb conservative. Ann Coulter. If they put her in that spot, people love her or hate her. She's not dumb, and she's not hypersensitive. Would play her what she does completely differently.
Of course.
So they don't put her there.
Opie, what's with the beard, man? Isn't that a little frightening for the baby? your boyish charm? Are you trying to, this grizzled
I look
fucking,
scary?
Yeah, it's not, I don't know, it doesn't seem to be you. I've never seen you with the whiskey
just fucking
booze.
Growing a beard.
Yeah, for the winter, you look... Winter coat. Yeah, it's all right.
It'll probably be shaved by the weekend. It'll be all right.
Don't shave it. I like
it. You like it, Bobby?
Let it grow.
You gotta let it grow out. It's weird.
Let it go. It looks good on you. And wear those fucking flannels. I'm gonna fucking have you come in with a thing of paper towels.
I was just gonna say that. God damn you.
Fuck you too.
Well, I wanted to say it.
Well, I was said it.
Well, you didn't say brawny. Fuck.
Well, I was said it without saying it. Fuck dick. Fuck.
Fuck. It's a brawny look.
Yeah.
Very paper towel.
The shirt is going to be in the garbage.
You leave it. You have to wear it.
It's a brawny look.
First of all, the shirt looks great. It goes with your skin.
It's a fucking brawny look.
The
combo, though, with the beard and the shirt.
That's poop. No.
Are you sure?
No, I didn't. I'm sure I didn't. If you know, my ass, it just felt like a zit popped in my asshole.
Move your ass back and forth from left to right.
Nope. Didn't
you sure?
Swear to God. Wow. Nope. But I like the look. Grow the beard out. It looks good. It's a new look for you, and you should grow it. Stop shaving your face. Grow a beard. Cover some of that.
I want Jimmy to fucking grow it, too.
Yeah, but you look good in a beard. He wouldn't look good in a beard.
Jimmy would look good in a beard.
No, he looks good with a beard. He doesn't... Ew. You know, get it like a gay guy.
That is. I don't know why I didn't laugh at that because it was funny.
It was a funny joke.
But I was too busy thinking of how bad I look in a real beard.
Have you ever grown a beard?
Yeah, but it just kind of comes. I look like a child with a fake beard taped
did
to me.
Did you trim it or you just grow the?
Can I just grow it? I didn't trim it. Yeah, it was kind of like Ted Kaczynski.
You know what, you know what he looks like when he grows a beard? A pug.
Really? Funny, man.
That's so wrong.
It's good. You were good in Men in Black. I love that.
Jimmy should get a pug.
You do. You look like a fucking
pug. You know how the owners look like their dogs? Did you put a pug? Can we get to the end of this clip?
Can we please just show a pug? I want to see.
Yeah, no problem.
I want Jimmy to see what he looks like as a dog when he grows a beard. Let's just look at a pug.
When you were saying.
Type it in, Sam!
Well, I gotta leave the clip.
Type the
first.
Fucking pug in. B-U-G.
We don't do view clips often. One is like a biggie because it's a comic thing.
Jim
Maher is getting attacked for a joke he did, and it's just not right. Yeah, by a woman deciding what's funny for everybody, and that drives us nuts on this fucking radio show.
But I love the fact that Barbara Walters and Joy Behar are leaving her hanging. I love the fact they're leaving her hanging.
They are. Oh,
she's delusional.
Pug!
You want pug or the last 10 seconds?
Let's
of the
do the 10 seconds, 10 and
seconds,
pug.
Then we go pug. Well
and then we go pug? All right, then we
you
go
hit
pug.
Me in the headphone.
People.
Yeah, I went through years of blah, 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 blah. I survived. And,
but my feelings weren't hurt. I'm speaking on behalf of women. We don't treat women in this country. It shouldn't be a global issue. And quite frankly, I know what's funny. I work with funnies. That wasn't funny.
Can we move on?
Did you see what she just did?
It was so great to be here. It was so great to be here on The View and to talk with all of you or one of you.
Well, you can talk about me or you can talk to me. I think accountability is sometimes important in life. That's what I teach my kids. We can go on now. What else do you feel about the world?
But don't.
Okay. Hello. Welcome to The View.
I think I'm being very well behaved.
When she was hurt, we love her and she's had her chance to
expect me. I said that before.
I have a question. You got a question?
She was
no,
hurt.
You are
yeah,
hurt.
She was
Elizabeth.
Hurt. And you know what? It's
I'm not Billy. Bull fucking shit.
You know what a comic's gonna someone's gonna have to go, fuck you. Someone like him is gonna have to go, enough, you fucking idiots.
No, she does it to herself. They left her hanging. That clip, how you're reacting, is how 90% of the people who see it will react.
Yeah.
And the beard would make the look perfect. I get it. I
so
get it,
$50
Bobby.
Rider.
Six pocketed. I guess I'm going to loosen up my guests.
I didn't know you were listening.
Wait. Same brown eyes. Nice too.
Wait, I gotta get the beard. Get the chin in. I need the chin. Yeah. Oh my God.
It's adorable.
It is cute though.
You're a cute dog.
Don't ask me to pose so you can do like a before and after shot.
I didn't say anything. I didn't even say a word to you.
You did turn toward his camera.
Yeah. You turned to you.
Jimmy knows
you,
when the cameras are on.
I do.
That's a good looking pug. That's because he's a press hound.
That's a cute dog. Look at that little eyes on that thing.
Yeah.
And Whoopi just sits there. What the fuck's that about?
She's
you're a comic. You know a little bit about this shit.
She's fucking farting.
Say something.
She's farting and stoned.
She's weird. Whoopi defends guys sometimes that she should and other times doesn't. She's kind of weird.
Yeah.
You don't know where she's going to go usually.
What a shit show.
Language.
Sorry.
But it's smart, though, because they get that reaction. If it was just purely logical, people wouldn't watch it. People wouldn't get angry at it or talk about it. Like, oh, yeah, they all made some sense.
But she actually said, she was saying all the key words to make women.
Sure.
It's not for me. It's for women around the...
She sucks. But Sherry Shepherd also sucks.
Fucking
and
asshole.
So did Star Jones. They always have somebody who really sucks. It's a smart mix of fucking people because... They get reactions out of people. You don't want to see five logical women discussing something because then you wouldn't have any reaction to it.
And you got Sherry Shepherd who thinks the fucking earth is flat.
There's
got
to be some static and opposing view for sure. Everybody agreeing would be the worst half hour.
It's got to be a little electricity.
Yeah. It's conflict.
Conflict.
That was electricity.
We have to take a break. When is your show be premiere?
My show?
Yeah.
The Pig Roast?
Yes, sir.
On www.pigroast.tv? That one?
Yes. November 22nd.
November 22nd.
That's just a coincidence about, you know, the Kennedy assassination. Well, I'm a big Kennedy buff. It
was
just
that the 22nd, really? I didn't know he was shot on the 22nd.
Yeah, there's no way to tribute a slain president better than a no-talent ventriloquist with a shitty production value in Hoboken.
Fuck it, Otto. The production value is terrific.
Should dig up Kennedy and just give him a eye poke just to see what condition
Which
he's
one?
In now.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, well, any of them.
Get three shovels.
The different degrees of dead.
There's four shovels.
Yeah, four. Yeah, there's a lot of dead Kennedys.
Yeah, there sure are. The good band.
We got a break just because of live read purposes.
All right, yes. I'm out of here, too. I got to go. I got to get my heart checked out.
And good then luck, you're going to lift cabinets, I hear.
Yeah,
dumb.
I got to meet her at...
Why would you do that?
He's going to go watch Little
about
Nicky.
He's worried about his heart, so he's getting his heart checked out, but you're not going to get the results. And then actually, right after the heart exam, he's going to go lift cabinets.
You're going to get a chest x-ray, like a whole thing?
I'm going to get... No, I'm getting a stress test.
Oh.
And then I'm getting my heart... an EKG. I'm getting my heart checked because I had a pain in my chest the other day.
After doing anything in particular?
Of breathing and drinking a soda.
Really?
I was just sitting there. Gas,
it might be heartburn from the soda.
Actually, we were in a heated debate.
You're getting a panic attack.
I've started getting panic attacks too since I quit smoking.
Yeah.
I never had one in my life. Now I'm getting panic attacks. Well, like, because, you know, we go on the road. I start having to pack the night before, and I start, where's my Q-tips? Where's my. Really? And all of a sudden, I start panicking.
Hire someone to do that!
And I hit my wife. I smack her right in the chin.
Oh, fuck.
Where's the fucking Q-tips?
You'll be fine. I really do
get panic attacks now that I quit smoking.
It is, yeah?
Yeah, it's 3 months, and I used to smoke a butt. I'd go have a cup of coffee before a show.
List more things.
Smoke before a show, after a show.
You're panicking right now.
Sometimes before an audition. I get on this show. I'd have a cigarette on it. Keep going.
Smoke to live and live to smoke.
Back after this.
All right.
The Opie and Anthony Channel. On Sirius XM.
The following sexually explicit CB radio transmission took place one evening in early 2010 between radio personalities Jim Norton and Anthony Cumia. Neither party has been made aware of its existence until now.
I'm thinking about you.
Yeah.
Did you get the video I sent?
Yeah.
I really do want to be rough with you.
Wow. Well, what do you want to do? What are you going to do to wear me out?
I want to treat you rough. Throw you around, spank and slap you, slap your face.
Yeah.
Treat you like a dirty little whore, put my cock in your ass and then shove it down your throat.
I want you to bite me.
Now you're talking? Then I'm gonna tell you to shut the fuck up while I slap your face and pull your hair for making noise.
Wow.
I want you to beg for my cock.
Yeah.
Kiss you all over to convince me to let you have it in your mouth. We will see how bad you want me.
Whatever else turns you on.
Whatever I want, you are mine. You please me like no other has or ever will. I'm not losing that. Great thing is we have a lifetime of this.
Okay, lights out. Good night, sexy.
SiriusXM. This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Got Bob Kelly and Otto from Otto and George. Let's not forget about the Pig Roast. Starts this coming Tuesday, November 22nd, on Pig Roast TV. Pigroast.tv.
What was that?
Pigroast.tv.
Jimmy Norton's birthday was the first show we're going to air, so that'll be a good one to kick it off with.
Nice.
Is it the first one?
We're showing them out of order because we figured you were the biggest name that we had.
I didn't think I was very good, though. You were funny. I didn't think I was very funny.
Well, I mean, what can you do? It was nothing to do. You're being interviewed. It's, you know,
yeah, it's true.
Comedians aren't good interviews and actors aren't good interviews. That's why we're trying to get more mentally ill people. They make the best interviews.
Yeah.
You know, there's nothing worse than hearing an actor or a comedian talk about their craft and
it is terrible.
Shops and all that shit. You know,
it's terrible.
It's horrible. I don't want to hear about your struggles. Because there are no struggles. We're spoiled babies.
I think a lot of people are going to check out Pig Roast. Opieanthony.com this coming Tuesday.
Yeah, I don't know how the internet goes, you know, how it's going to spread virally, but I just think people just talk about it, you know. I fucking worked really hard on this thing.
Well, I mean, you know, there's probably clips within the show that could go viral, too, for you. You know what I mean?
We had some crazy shit that happened. Good. Yeah, definitely.
Who's on the hotline? Hello?
You know what, dude? You get your EKG, you get a cup of coffee. You know what, dude?
I was trying to figure out
who's doing
is.
You.
No, I know.
Fuck that cock. Yeah, I don't know much about the internet, you fucking half Danish, too chunky.
Otto calling in.
Right.
I figured I'd work a phone because I finally got untied myself. Hey, it's Jay. How are you, boys?
Jay Moores.
I'm excited about, first of all, Bobby Kelly's broken the top 40 on his fucking podcast. You know what, dude? Kudos to Bobby.
And Jay's, your podcast is fucking great, too, by the way. More stories.
Mine was number one until I got Colin on, and then it fucking debuted at number 10 because he's anti-American, that fucking asshole.
He fucked up your fucking ranking.
I was number one like 11 weeks in a row, you know, it's top five, and then I get Colin on, and I just barely creep in where fucking Doug Loves Movies is usually at.
That's a podcast humor?
Dude, he's just funny. Yeah,
I love it.
Jimmy, first of all, we talk about Otto and George for a good 10 minutes.
Yeah, thanks. I heard that for your kind words, Jay. Thank you.
It's idolatry, and we break down the psychosis and the genius of what it takes for Otto, for when George makes fun of an audience member, the psychosis that has to go into the transaction of thought. Like fucking Otto has to spot the person and then do, like, fucking two bits. And then the fucking puppet looks over like he's just fucking discovering it for the first. Look at this fucking cocksuck over here.
Creating the illusion, yeah.
Oh, my God. It's fascinating. And it's great. And we were in hysterics. Like, the podcast closes with, like, 11 minutes of Otto ball watching.
But fucking Colin fucked it up for you.
Yeah, you know, but this might save it.
Yeah.
There's something on the podcast that the pests might love. And, you know, I don't make any money. I don't have any fucking sponsors or do Fleshlight or anything. Oh, but so it's not for that reason, but it is truly because people will like it, I think, is I do a Chip Chipperson impression.
What's that?
It's like 45 minutes in. And Colin, somebody put it up on Twitter. And I retweeted it, but I don't know where it is. So whoever is listening that put that, if anybody can isolate the 30 seconds of audio, I do Chip, and Colin literally makes an exclamation like he's having a heart attack.
Jesus. I want to hear this.
We're
talking about Genesis. I asked him what his favorite book of the Bible was, and he says Revelations, and I make fun of him. Like, that's, what are you, fucking Jerry Bruckheimer? Like, crabs crawling out of the ocean, you hack. He's like, well, what do you want from me? You know, what's your favorite book of Marvel? You know? And anyway, we start talking about Genesis and Sodom and Gomorrah, and I go, he says, you know, the poor guy's wife turned to salt. You know, what are you supposed to do? And I go, she was a real salty broad or something. And he goes, oh, and he actually fucking clutched his chest. And it wasn't like, so he didn't plan it out, like, if Jay does Chip, I'll fucking do this. Like, it was a visceral fucking grab, oh, like, grabbed his chest.
Yeah, but it doesn't make sense, because you didn't do, I would have done a joke good. Like, if you said something about the ladies made of salt, I would have said, why don't you throw on some eggs or something?
Oh, fucking hate it.
And then Colin goes into, wait, Opie, you hate Chip?
No, I hate Chip.
I like Chip.
You don't like Chip.
I play the role of hating him on the show.
And then Colin goes into, like, this incredible detailed explanation of Chip when he shows up at the Comedy Cellar, makes his jokes, but if you look at him, you could see the fucking hatred in Chip's eyes. Like, and I wanted to say to Colin, like, you know that's Jimmy, right?
Well, you have Jay's Chip impression?
Yes, I do.
Oh, fuck. Okay, good.
I want to talk about the pig roast. Why doesn't he go to a fucking Blockbuster and stand next to Suicide Kings and try to get spotted? I want to talk about the fucking pig roast. He's established, this asshole. He's got to call in and talk for fucking 40 minutes now? Every fucking time. Which fucking attention does he need? Jerk off. Back to your little fucking man cave. Go fuck yourself. Talk about my pig roast.
What's that? What's that? A dinner or something?
Ugh.
See, I make it all better.
Chip, shut up, Chip. I hate
Oh my god, this is.
Hey, Bobby, still there?
Yes, he is.
I have to go. I have a heart exam at 9:40.
I have a heart attack already.
When Bobby was explaining,
they want to spend a weekend over here. He touching everything. I you know you're a golf score. Hey, what a touch. They want to spend a weekend near Langford.
King of comedy.
Yeah,
I'm in. You're out. You didn't know.
When Bobby explained packing the night before a flight, he said...
Wait, Jay's just going to move on from the Toronto thing. We're so dysfunctional on this show.
Huh?
We're dysfunctional on this show.
So Bobby goes, you know, when I got a pack for a gig, I'm like, where are my Q-tips? That was the first thing that rolled out of Bobby's mouth. Where are my Q-tips? When he's got his luggage out, where are my Q-tips?
I got to have my Q-tips. So cleaning my ears is one of my favorite things to do.
Oh, my God. Yeah. Well, don't break my balls, Otto. You were my number 8 pick in my fantasy comedy draft on Twitter.
Oh, yeah? What does that mean?
It means that there was a draft and you was drafted.
Oh, like a football analogy? Oh, well, all right. Guess
what is it? Was it cold in here or something?
Yeah. Drafty. What do you need, a towel or something?
Otto wants to talk about the pig roast.
Yeah, I want to talk about the pig roast, too. I think it's a great idea.
I gotta go. Why are you leaving? I got my heart thing.
Why don't you say a few nice things about the pig roast first? Don't cut out.
First of all, I fucking watched the pig roast. I talked to you about the pig roast.
Yeah, we had a good talk.
I think
yeah.
It's very funny. It's kind of fucking. There's a lot of hot chicks on it, and I think it's fucking hilarious. You should go check out the pig roast. What's the name of the website again?
www.pigroast.tv.
.tv.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I'm a talentless host, but that seems to be what works on television. Minimal amount of talent and just bring good guests on. You know, the show is as good
and
or bad
tits.
As my guest.
And tits.
There's always tits. I learned that from Benny Hill.
Right.
Shove a hot ass into the camera.
Benny Hill.
Yeah, I mean,
that's true.
How could you go wrong?
Never show tits, but have the illusion that a tit might pop
Fast out. Fast motion tits?
Yeah.
You going fast motion tits like Benny Hill used to?
Yeah, that's a good idea. In high
Let's
heels,
go fast
why
motion.
The fuck not? Yeah.
Let's do fast motion like boobies.
And do slow motion assholes.
Slow motion assholes. What a fucking concept.
Yeah, there you go. Fast motion titties.
Yeah.
You're nervous about this one, aren't you? The pig roast. You're a little nervous.
Otto, will you tweet me the link, and then I'll retweet the link and tell everybody to go watch the picture.
We'll all tweet it, yeah.
Yeah, tweet. Okay, sure.
I don't know nothing about computers.
I don't.
Look at me. I got a fucking mullet. You see the clip of us at the Orlando Improv? Look at this fucking crew cut, this fucking faggot.
What the fuck?
Lonely man.
Kelly. Look at Bob.
No one's picking up on it. we got the chip
this
clip.
This is fucking hilarious. I gotta hear the chip clip before I leave.
You sure, Bobby?
I fucking hate
chip. You gotta lift cabinets today.
I gotta
hear the chip clip.
All right, can we hear the chip clip?
Perfectly round human.
All right, this is more stories. Episode 19. Chip shows up in the podcast, so this is isolated from the podcast. Hit it.
And let's lay down with him.
It's kind of hot, I guess, but it's pretty sick.
I mean, literally hot because it's on fire around them. I don't want you to think I noticed.
I like the quality of your podcast, Jay.
Yeah. Cool. Pause. Real quick. Pause. You record it in a conch shell?
What the fuck?
What do you get? You guys
hey, Opie, why don't you talk to your friend Kevin Smith about the whole New York podcast?
Well, what the fuck is going on with the fucking sound of the Jay Moore podcast? You deserve better than that, sir.
People showed up in my hotel room, dropped mics on the table, said, here you
go.
All right, that's fair enough.
He should have gave you some unis.
Yeah.
And instead you have omnis.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, it sounds like you're doing your podcast underwater.
Or in the shower.
Or on a conch shell.
Yeah,
like
or
I
in
said.
A conch shell.
Or on a raft.
Jay Moore deserves better. He was the number one podcast.
Yeah, in a bat cave.
All right, we'll try to.
With a fucking Q-tip, whoopie fucking do over here.
I know why that sounds crappy, and it might not be him. It's the he saved it in a lower quality MP3
Bob
file.
Kelly can take care of you, so it doesn't sound like it's underwater. But besides that, we'll make believe it's not underwater, and we'll listen for the quality of the comments.
Yes.
Okay. All right, here we go.
Been literally hot because it's on fire around them. I don't want you to think I noticed hot to sleep with your
daughter. Yeah, because the wife is a pillow of salt.
Yeah, you know. Anyway.
She's a salty broad, huh?
Yeah. That's something Chip Chipper would say.
Oh. You clutched your heart. Like the guy in the big picture. Yeah. You just clutched your heart.
How old are these people? Oh. Early 40s. Oh, Chipperson. Oh.
She's a real salty broad or something. Huh? With those angry eyes over his childhood trauma with his mother. He's like, he just looks at you like this at the cellar.
Who, Jenny?
Chip.
Oh,
yeah. He looks at you, but he's trying to be funny, but his eyes are so angry. It's really sick. Oh, evil.
I would like Matthew.
It's a bunch of bullshit. What are you, roasting pigs or something?
Chip does get mad once in a while at you.
I don't like being made fun of.
What?
I like how I go, who, Jimmy? And Colin goes, no, Chip.
I like that he has a backstory for Chip.
Yeah.
Pig roast.
The pig roast.
Yeah, Jay, this is pig roast time.
What's the address for that, Otto?
We don't want to get yelled at, so, you know, this is pig roast time, Jay.
Why don't you have me on your pig roast or something? Then I'll really make
you'll
it.
Be on
don't touch
you're
me.
Very funny.
See, he gets angry. You got to be careful. Where the eyes bug out?
On that Teletubby that was called Tony the Cuntlapper. Produce it with my check. It's a fucking pig roast, you fucking half-spoke.
Jay, would you do the pig roast?
Of course I would.
Why don't you have Jay on when you guys are you done taping?
Otto, would you have Jay on?
Well, we tape in New York. That's the only problem. I mean, it's hard getting guests to
New York.
Planes
that fucking come
in. Jay doesn't come to New York.
Too bad you can't tape.
Too bad he doesn't come to New York often.
See if Fez will let you get Ron Bennington on.
Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. Oh, he said it.
Fez is supposedly making us Thanksgiving dinner on Friday, I'm hearing.
I am excited about the pig roast. Please tweet me, Otto, so I can retweet it.
That would be great. I need help. I need fucking...
And Otto, we're helping you. We're going to go with fast motion tits and slow motion assholes. or at least slow motion asses bouncing up and down a little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit. A little jiggle.
A little apple ball.
Do that slow motion, you're going to fucking see the numbers go up.
Yeah.
What else can we give Otto today?
I tried to get one of the piglets on today. I got in touch with Travis, and he said he would ask... Did he ask you guys about...
No.
I couldn't understand why you didn't immediately say, bring her, because she was going to, you know, come up here dressed like a whore and you guys could just look at her.
Can we throw stuff at her?
Whatever.
No.
Can we throw bacon at her?
No. Yeah. I wanted to bring her up.
I was thinking staplers.
I was thinking raw bacon.
Raw bacon?
Yeah, slat so it sticks to her.
I just want to look at a pussy.
Jesus, Chip.
Let me suck her tits or something.
Chip. Jesus.
Throw it down and call her pig roast bitch.
Chip, you should work clean.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
What's that?
You should work clean.
I do.
Yeah.
I would say I want to kiss a cuda.
I don't think Mr. Leno would like that language.
I don't know. I've never been on his show. Jim doesn't have the courage to do me when he's around.
He really doesn't.
Jim isn't that stupid. Jim likes to have fun on the radio. Jim's not going to bomb in front of 4 million people.
Oh, I'd love to see you get courage one night.
Jay wouldn't go, hey, that's Chip, that's funny. He would go, what are you doing?
And then he'd go,
he wouldn't go with it.
No, he's just,
nobody should go with it.
It's perfect for this throwaway show.
It's fun. We have 5 hours or 4 hours a day. It's different. People get it, but how many? Fucking 4 minutes.
Yeah. Jay, anything on the Yoo-Hoo?
Yoo-Hoo is rocketing out of my asshole.
What are you trying to do, Ob? We're having a good time over here.
How's up the house?
We're having a good time over here. What are you trying to do? You're trying to fucking, hey, spider.
I'm just trying to lighten it up a little bit. I'm trying to lighten it up, Sam. What's wrong with you? And he did pick you in the draft, Otto. I saw.
You know what doesn't get enough traction that Otto says is, sugar.
What's the story with Patrice? A lot of people are asking me about him on the road and stuff. It's
we
an extended
don't, honestly,
family.
We addressed it this morning. We just don't know.
You don't know anything?
No.
We don't know. We have no new info.
How do you not know, though? That's what makes people crazy.
It is what it is, brother.
It's crazy for us, too, dude.
We have to wait for the family. It's with a stroke.
Oh.
It's like, it's one of these things that it doesn't just happen immediately. I'm not a doctor. I don't know. I've heard it can go good, it can go bad. I don't want to speculate on Patrice's health. I don't know.
Yeah.
It's like, if I knew, I would tell you. I would tell anybody.
But is there an update at all?
The same thing. The family is keeping everything close to the vest. We haven't been up. No one's been up to see him. You know, right now he just got out of ICU because that's why we couldn't see him. And he just, you know, he's the same thing. So it sucks for everybody because we want to know
him.
Too. It just fucking sucks, you know.
I want to see him.
Yeah.
So.
What hospital is he in? Oh, you can't say.
Yeah, I'm not gonna say him where he is.
Oh.
Not on the air. I mean, I'll tell you personally, but yeah.
That's rough.
It's fucking
rough.
He'd
be a great guest on the pig roast. So right when he gets healthy.
Yeah. I mean, sure. I mean, I can't imagine what he's thinking, not being able to verbalize.
I don't know if he can or not, to be honest with you. Yeah. I don't know. I honestly do not know.
Yeah.
I gotta go.
When's the pig roast?
I gotta go. I'll talk to you later. Jay, nice talking to you.
You know what?
Congratulations on fucking number one and being a number 10.
Number 10.
I'm a number 40.
No, I'm nobody you up. Jay. You, and I block everybody that Bobby blocks and everybody that Opie blocks. It's a wonderful game.
Good. I block whoever you block now. I like that game.
That's what I do now, too.
Yeah.
We're a team.
Did you get knocked down to 10 because of the qualities of the actual podcast?
Well, nobody knows the quality. When people subscribe to it, they don't know the... You know what? Look, there's a lot going on that, you know...
But I'm thinking
Can I
that,
just say something?
No, because I'm thinking it's word of mouth, so someone might have, like, said, you know what, this week, it's, the quality is a little rough. And maybe that fucked you up a little
there's,
bit.
there's things before the podcast that make people a little angry.
I don't know what that means.
What do you mean?
Oh.
What?
I know what that is.
Commercials?
Yeah.
Kevin Smith, they've got a lot of commercials before the...
Who said that? Who fucking said that?
I did.
Sam
I
and listen- E-Rock. I'm out of this
what
one.
What are you saying, Sam? How could you say both things?
I listen to the Smodcast Network. They're great podcasts.
Great
podcasts. I believe what you're referring to.
Like, it's almost like the Glory Hole Network.
That's another great
Glory Hole.
We're not talking about the pig roast!
Glory Hole Radio. I gotta go. I gotta go make
Why
sure
are you
my
leaving?
Heart... Because I might die.
You're not gonna fucking die. You had gas, stupid.
Exactly. It's everyone around you who's gonna die.
It'd be funny if the doctor said
You're
that.
Killing everyone around you, Leon.
Pig roast. More stories tomorrow, and then gloryholeradio.com for the you know what, dude. Podcast.
I'm looking at that hat, just thinking how good a fucking.
Bobby wants reassurance from a man in a white coat. He doesn't want to exactly
good humor man.
Him a
Let's organize
checkup.
A little bit. Bobby's stepping out, so you're out.
I gotta go. I gotta go. Fucking
you did
do
a great
my stress
job today, Bobby.
Thank you very much.
I hope a fucking bullet tears through that hat.
Why?
I'm walking out the door.
It would just be,
fucking
fun to see you get a fucking bullet through your head.
But why does it have to be through the hat?
Because I hate your hat.
Just say you hate the hat. Why does everything have to bullet with you? Bullet.com. Bullets. More bullets. Shut up. We get it. You want things dead, stupid. Fuck. I wish you were dead. How's that sound? You fucking pug shit.
Oh, yeah?
Goodbye.
At least my heart's okay.
Jesus. Christ almighty.
What the fuck, man?
I don't know. You got to make fun of me or something.
What the fuck?
Now you're worried about your heart.
I'll see you later. No, you see my hat? No, you can't see anything.
Why is Jay
so haunting?
I hope you fall down the steps with a cabinet or something on your chest.
Why do you hate his hat? Because of the low quality of it?
This is a high quality hat.
Not a high quality hat.
That's a fucking loser.
High quality hat going over something empty.
Very cheap, thin cardboard rim on that.
That's not a cardboard rim.
What's the name of the hat?
That's a fucking John Vixon.
It's not.
Can I see it?
It's a John Vixon fucking Scally's
hat. Is that a black guy's hat? Like you wear it backwards?
Yeah,
it is.
That's black cock.
Goodbye. I'll
see you, Bobby.
All right, Bobby is gone.
That's good. Good luck.
You'll be fine.
Bob Kelly on Twitter, right? Or Robert Kelly. Robert Kelly on Twitter.
If this is the last time I see you, remember I love you.
45 minutes, I'm gonna fucking half walk out the door.
What's wrong with you?
I'm just saying, if you happen to die today, I love you.
Are you out of your mind?
No, because nobody dies when someone says that to him. No one dies when they say that to
him. Yeah, it's always Bobby, it's always too late.
I used to say to my girlfriend all the time, unless I'm killed in a plane crash, I'll see you soon. Because no one ever dies in a plane crash after saying that.
I didn't know.
I enjoyed my time with you at Fly Fishing
Graveyard.
Just so you know that. I just staring at that light. Just know that.
I do hope he gets clipped by a truck hauling Diet Shasta as he steps off the curb on the way out of the building and then really needs a doctor.
Pig roast. Pigroast.tv.
Sam, what were you going to say?
Oh, shit.
What's that?
This is a stirring the shit thing.
It's not stirring the shit.
It's stirring the shit.
I listen to Smodcast all the time.
What's the problem?
What were you going to say? It sounded like you were going to say something.
Because Jay was talking about what happens before the podcast, and before all the Smodcasts, they put a lot of commercials.
Like how many? Because I don't listen to I skip forward.
There's enough that...
But what are the commercials for?
They're for other things on the Smodcast Network. And
how many minutes would you say it goes on? Because I don't even know.
It's several minutes. I mean, it's long. And long enough that me and my fiance were listening to Jay Moore's podcast in the car and said, Jesus Christ, another commercial.
Yeah, but they got to pay these guys somehow.
They got to pay the bills.
You got to have commercials are necessary.
But they're paying themselves. What Sam is saying is commercials for their own shows.
It's commercials. I mean, it's not.
Is it a necessary evil?
It's commercials for other smodcasts. I mean,
okay.
Would that be a necessary evil?
I wouldn't. I mean, I don't have the business model, but I wouldn't think it's necessary.
How big is the Marc Maron show? Is that pretty up there?
It's the biggest in the world. He's the fucking CNN of podcasts.
He is, yeah. He's got so many comedian interviews, though. He's been doing it. It took Marc 3 years to get any traction on that. I mean, but he's been busting his ass for a long time.
He's the godfather right now.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Here's the good news for anybody in the audience that listens to Marc's podcast. You can know as a fundamental truth that he fucking hates you.
Yeah.
Whereas I like you. Talk about the pig roast, you fucking balding, washed up fucking hack. Remember that time in that movie I made that no one saw, you fucking Danish Jew junkie? I saw your movie on an airplane. I fucking jumped out. All right. I just thought you guys would enjoy Colin going,
We did. Absolutely.
All right. Don't make a big deal.
What does Colin do? He did that HBO thing. What does he do? Does he do The Road?
He's on The Road a little bit. Yeah, he went out for a few months.
Working on my manifesto.
He seems like he'd be very unhappy on The Road. Like, he's got to be in
He's unhappy in New York. He's unhappy on HBO. He's unhappy everywhere.
Really?
And yes, he's like a thin-fingered idiot.
His thing now is to have everybody on Twitter hate him.
Yeah.
He's going for Twitter hate,
He's great on Twitter. Yeah. So funny.
Otto, pig roast. This is the big premiere with Jimmy, right?
Yeah, man.
Star of the Antisocial Tour.
Yeah.
When's the next Antisocial appearance, Jimmy?
It's funny. You should say that, Jay. It's January 15th in the Borgata. The 14th is sold out, yeah. So let's hope it goes well.
It'll go well. We'll add a second show. We'll get you up and running in no time.
Second show's already added. First one sold out very quickly. Second show's taking longer since it's a Sunday show.
But doing well.
Oh, yeah.
We talk about the fucking pig roast. Right here. I'm fucking sitting around with, I look like Gene Simmons.
Oh. What happened?
You think Jay's out of his mind.
Jay?
Yeah.
All right.
I thought I looked like Gene Simmons was going to be the big closer.
I didn't get the Gene Simmons line, I think.
Yeah.
You look like Gene Simmons?
No, George looks like fucking Gene Simmons.
Oh, George.
He's a more believable wig.
You know what?
Same hairdo.
You know what? That should have got a laugh.
Look at what the fuck? Out of all the fucking puppets, you take the one that looks like Gene Simmons? Get the Ace Frehley puppet. He's available. I gotta go.
Rejection. Bye.
All right, Jay. Jay Moore's. Jay Moore 37 on Twitter. Pigroast.tv.
Yeah, it should be
this coming Tuesday. So what can we look forward to as far as the pig roast season goes on?
That's a good question.
How many episodes?
We shot 10. We have a recording star from Italy. I forget her name. A lot of musical acts. We didn't want to just do comedy because all I could bring was comedy. They were relying on me to bring the acts in, so I was trying to have maybe one comic every other show. I didn't want it to be a stand-up show.
How many guests a show?
We have a lot. We've been averaging 4 or 5 guests for a half-hour show, which is a lot, right?
I don't know.
But we cut the interviews down. We keep cutting them down to make them,
Who else was on my show?
There was a lot of guys on your show. Kevin, Begorn, that band Begorn. I can't remember the order because it was all big. It was like going to another planet every time we shot. And then by the end, we were shooting 2 in one day because they were running out of money to produce it, and they found out it was cost the same to shoot 2 in one day as 1.
Yeah, that's why you always do 2 shows in one day because the chart you pay less on the theater expenses. If it's, yeah,
and what happens? You go to pigroast.tv and then starting Tuesday,
is it .com or .tv?
.tv.
You could just
watch it.
Yeah, I think it's going to start airing
at your leisure.
Yeah, exactly. And you could watch the other. If you miss a show, you can. It'll always be available, and there'll be a lot of extra bonus shit. I think it's going to start airing during the middle of the day. I thought he was going to air it at like 8 or 9 at night, but I think he's just going to start it in the morning and just see who really.
Yeah, just get it up there
with the web. Things can go out.
Because you're looking at total views, right?
Yeah.
Then it doesn't matter. Having, yeah, first thing in the morning. Fuck it. If it starts Tuesday, get it up Tuesday.
Now, what about nice tweeting? How do I tweet Jay? I don't know anything about that. He wanted me to tweet his...
You just tweet. You don't do it now. Do it the night before.
The information.
Tell people, or the day it's coming out. Hey, guys, today it's right now. It's on.
Right.
Because people, especially with Twitter, it's very immediate. No one's going to, you're not going to Twitter something today and people go, oh, great, in 6 days, do it the day of or the day before.
Okay.
Because it's so quick now. People just go right to it. I just snapped. That implies quickness.
On Tuesday, we'll all just tweet the shit out of it.
Okay.
That's how it's going to work.
That's how it goes down? Okay.
Yeah. I mean, we'll talk about it on the air.
You can tweet a little bit ahead of time, but Tuesday is the important day to just get it out, everybody.
And they can always go back and watch it, too. If it's the second weekend and someone hears about it, they'll go back and watch it.
Yeah.
I got to talk about girls. Girls?
Yes.
Oh, girls. Ever wonder what it would be like to dance on stage at a strip club?
Oh, boy.
And now, the Opie and Anthony Show continues. This is After O&A Live. Here's your host, Sam Roberts.
Opie, you're still technically in the studio. It's After Opie and Anthony Live, brought to you by Trojan Bearskin Condoms. Trojan America's... Oh, there's the boss, number one most trusted condom brand. Opie went the hard route. Otto's still here.
Hey.
Jim, you're still technically here.
Yeah.
Kenny's still here.
I have a meeting.
Club Soda Kenny on Facebook.
Oh, good. I'm glad you got that in.
Kenny. See you tomorrow.
Opie always talks about how tough it is trying to figure out where he's, whether he's going to stay here and get stuck in the studio doing radio or go outside and talk to the bosses when they're outside.
Are they outside?
Yeah, one of them's out there.
Which one?
Gary.
Okay.
I mean, I'm sure that they're not talking about bad things. They're probably just talking about the Hard Rock event tomorrow. But still. And it looks like they're waiting for you.
They don't need me.
Hiding from the teacher.
Yeah, exactly. That's what we do in here, Otto.
No,
yeah.
They don't need me. They could just do what they got to do.
Are you excited about the Hard Rock tomorrow?
I am, actually. I love live. I could do one a week, live events. They're my favorite thing to do on the show.
They're fun.
They're really fun. They're easy. I say easy because you're just goofing with people. And with radio, we don't have reaction. As comedians, we're used to... You know, a push and pull with an audience, but on radio, you have the room, but you don't have an audience.
And that's what happened the last time we went to the Hard Rock, like, a couple of months ago, and, like, we filled up the place, and it seemed like everybody on the show forgot that there are people actually interested in the show. Like, we forgot that there are listeners and people who are, like, cheering and laughing at this, because it had been so long.
Satellite's really scary sometimes, because you just don't know who's listening, because there's no Arbitron system, or there's no... Whatever, the PMs. Whatever.
Sure, people meters.
I notice it when I'm on the road in places I've never been to. Like in Utah, the four shows were mobbed, and I've never been to Salt Lake, and we were never on regular radio there. So it's like sometimes you got to go outside the area to realize, wow, people do listen to this show.
Yeah. The floor seating that was reserved is all gone. It was gone in like 45 minutes for the Hard Rock show.
Yeah, but come by, because you will get in.
Yeah, because the whole upper section is being opened. So we're gonna have room for like 400 people.
Yeah,
so everybody's gonna have room. So come down to the Hard Rock tomorrow in Times Square. It's at 8 in the morning, and we're gonna be there until 11, doing all kinds of stuff. And you guys are gonna be signing those Iron Sheik pictures. We had them printed. We actually have them. So Otto, have you seen that? You know the wrestler, the Iron Sheik.
Yeah, of course.
He was in here, and he was yelling, and throughout the interview. He got this little piss stain on his pants.
Oh.
See you later, Jim.
Bye, Jim.
He got
Bye,
this little Jimmy. Piss stain on his pants.
Yeah.
And as the interview went on, he yelled harder, and the piss stain just started growing and growing.
Oh, my God.
He didn't know it was there. You looking at the picture? Yeah. He didn't know this piss stain was there, so everybody wanted him to pose for pictures with them afterwards. So we're blowing up that picture with the Iron Sheik piss stain. We're going to have him 8x10s, and Opie, Anthony, and Jim are all going to... Sign the pictures for fans.
Jeez, he's a mess, huh?
Tomorrow at the Hard Rock.
He wasn't aware that he pissed himself?
He had no idea. Bad. Look how big the stain is.
Wow.
He had no idea.
Well, you gotta remember, it started off with him sitting on the couch.
Yeah.
And Voss pointed it out, and then all of a sudden the circle just kept getting bigger and bigger and bigger throughout the entire interview.
Yeah, but then it gets cold after a while, doesn't it get cold?
Like, you think any liquid that's like on your pants, like once you stand up and your pants start to adjust, you think you feel that your pants are
he's
all
out of it.
He really was out of it. He had been drinking quite a bit that day.
What, at 5 in the morning?
Because, he was drinking Beck's.
He went on Howard's show before us, and they gave him all kinds of beer.
Oh.
And then he came on to our show. He probably had 5 beers with us.
Oh,
so I had no idea. By 9 o'clock, he was gone. He was drunk enough that he pissed himself and had no idea.
That's so bad.
That's awesome. But yeah, like Jim said, it is amazing that you don't realize people are listening. Like yesterday on the after show, like I always assume there's like a handful of people listening to this. Yeah. But all day, we talked about the after show was completely mundane yesterday. We talked about me getting razor bumps because my hair is curly.
Right.
And then Larry the Cable Guy was on and just kind of talked about a contest he was promoting, and that was it. Like it was, I was like, ah, whatever.
That's a huge guess.
I know. I had no idea. All day. Every replay, people are tweeting me and sending me stuff saying, that was awesome with Larry the Cable Guy. You forget that this guy's gigantic.
Yeah, he sells out fucking football stadiums.
And that's what he said. He was in here, and he was like, yeah, you know, you find out you have a lot of fans somewhere, and the town doesn't have a theater, but they have a basketball stadium, so you play the basketball stadium. You go, what?
Fucking believable.
It's not even relatable at all.
Yeah.
Basketball stadium. And then people are tweeting me and sending me feedback on the website and everything, talking about giving me shaving tips.
Really?
It's like, I thought this was the most boring thing that's ever happened. But it's funny. I think we're all pretty excited about the pig roast.
What kind of shaving tips did he give?
Because you see, I get these razor bumps here. Yeah. I get all these and Jim was asking me about how I get rid of them, and I just told him the straight answer. There was no jokes. I said, you just use a single razor blade instead of the razor blades with... No, like the throwaway Bic razor blades that have one blade instead of four.
Is that better for you? Yeah.
For me, yeah, because I guess it pulled... But this is what I'm saying. See, this is not like an interesting, specifically, conversation.
Have you tried different shaving creams, the gel and all that shit?
I've tried
electric?
A couple, and then today, Bob Kelly came in, and he goes... Yeah, people were tweeting me, telling me to give you shaving tips, and he gave me advice for shaving cream. It's amazing the things that just start here. But everybody's pretty excited about the pig roast, because this is something, like, you started the pig roast, your internet TV show, way back, like, months ago, right?
Started shooting it. It was in fucking middle of the heat wave, and we were in this metal building in Hoboken, so it was like an oven in there. And they finally blocked the skylights out, which were like acting as like magnifying glass. It was so fucking hot in there.
No AC, I'm assuming.
There was AC cranking, but it didn't do shit because of the studio lights and everything.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, so you had the skylight that's just baking you, and then all the studio lights shining on you?
Yeah, and then one taping, George's mouth mechanism broke, so that caused a panic, and we had to rig him up, so... I was working, it was hard to describe, but I was working backwards. Instead of pulling the lever down to open the mouth, I had to keep it down to keep the mouth shut. In other words, if I wasn't touching the mouth mechanism at all, the mouth would just, like, open slack jaw.
So it's not like, you were talking about keeping up the illusion before. That completely just demystifies everything.
Yeah, I had to do everything backwards. That day, so I've been through some hellish experiences during the shooting, so I was just grateful when the heat started to subside. You know?
How many episodes did you tape?
We taped 10.
Oh wow!
Yeah, it was brutal. And they're handing you shit every 4 seconds, changing lines on you, and it was like a whirlwind. You know, it felt good when the day was done because I knew I had done a lot.
Yeah,
but it wasn't enjoyable, the actual doing of it.
How many episodes were you taping in a day?
The last four we did in 2 days. So, but before that we were doing one. We were doing just one show a day.
Because you don't want to get burned out. Like you're doing three, like those game shows. They tape like 9 game shows in one day, and that's where. But there's nothing to them. It's just like, all right, get them up here.
The money is a great incentive. I had never worked this hard for no cash at all, zero cash. Just the hope that the thing takes off.
Right.
And then having to be in every sketch and every facet of the show.
Right.
And I kept telling myself the night before, like, I'm going to really, like, be in the moment and enjoy the doing of it. But it's not possible.
No.
It's too much work.
And plus, your name is plastered on it. So it's like you can't, if you do give up control, then all of a sudden this guy that you've given up control to has complete control over your name.
Yeah.
So you have to work your ass off.
Otherwise, I only had one meltdown where I knew I'd sucked and the show sucked and I was horrible and it's a waste of time.
What happened?
I just had a bad tape go off in my head that I sucked and I was talentless. You know, just shit that my mother said to me years ago, resurfacing. So the producer came over to me and he goes, you got this look on your face. He goes, everybody's like you. You know, you're the source of everybody's enthusiasm. If I lose enthusiasm, the whole thing goes into the shitter.
Sure.
So he got me out of it. I was just having a bad
you know. Did you go off on anybody, or were you just collapsing inside yourself?
It was towards the end of a day, and I was kind of rude to this comedian. He said I was really rude to this comedian, but I just didn't know what to ask him. He'd only been doing it like a month.
Am I interviewing you about?
Yeah, it's like, you know, I don't know. I didn't know what to say to him. I guess I was in some kind of a trance because I don't even remember being rude. After that, I put on a better face.
Is it tough for you to be a host? Like, I don't know if that's something you're used to. I don't know if...
I had no experience with that at all, but it's just trying... I was just trying to have a natural curiosity.
Yeah.
And my out was that if the interview sucked, George would just attack me and the guest. You know, so I had that
and
going.
And that way, if George is attacking you and the guest, you're like, look, we're all taking it. Yeah, so it's just you attacking someone.
Yeah, it's true. I get most of the lashes that way. Yeah, that's true. I'm not just picking on the guest. We would discuss, you know, who to be, like, reverential to. Like, we almost had on Pat Cooper, but at the last minute he went, I'm 84. I'm not coming. I'm 84. Come to the Friars Club. Awesome. Yeah, we want to do a whole show with Cooper. But he just said, I'm 84. Fuck it. Come to the Friars Club, you know.
Can he sit in there? Huh? Can he sit in here? Yeah, sure. Who is that? David from Israel?
Yeah.
Oh, he's a fan. He's a super fan. Of course, yeah.
From Israel?
Wow. David from Israel. You've called in a bunch of times. What's up?
You were sitting out there when I first got here.
Yep.
You're from Israel?
Yep.
Really? Are you in the military?
Nope.
No?
Grab the mic.
Do you live in Israel?
Yep.
Wow.
How'd you get exposed to this show?
Because I listened before I moved.
Oh, I see. And what do you listen online?
Yep.
What's the Israel ONA community like? Is there a lot of fans?
No clue.
What do you mean, no clue? You don't talk to people?
Nope.
What do you do in Israel then?
Yeah,
I'm starting to have one of those meltdowns during this interview right now. What?
I work like a good Jew and make money.
That's right.
What kind of work do you do?
Soft switch engineer.
Yeah. What's Israeli food like? Like hummus and falafel and shit.
I don't eat that shit. I eat American food.
You eat American food there? Is there like good deli, like corned beef and shit, if you want it?
That's too stereotypical. We don't eat that there.
That's a New York Jew food. That's not an Israeli.
Jew from Brooklyn, to be particular. Right.
What do you get there? Like, what kind of American food do they have in Israel?
Hamburgers, hot dogs, chicken.
Okay.
Whatever you guys eat.
Well, did you move to Israel for the work?
I went there for vacation. I found a pretty good job, so I stayed.
Who finds a job while they're on vacation?
Shit happens.
You went there on a vacation. That's interesting.
Nobody can find a job here when they're looking for jobs, and you find a job while you're on vacation in Israel. I guess so.
I'm making there more double than I ever made over here.
Jesus. Wow.
And I have a pretty good position over there. I run a company, so...
You run a company?
I run the technical side, so.
So who's running it now?
I'm still working, even though I'm on vacation.
Oh, Jesus. Oh.
Like I said, us Jews like making a lot of money.
I guess so. Enough.
What is the danger ratio there as far as a missile taking a leg off or something like that? Is that an everyday occurrence, or is that like they always go, it's another part of town. I don't believe that shit for a second.
Well,
it
depends where you are. There are also the occasional bombings.
Yeah.
But security there is very tight, and it's
The occasional bomb. You talk about that like you're in New York. Yeah, there's a blizzard every once in a while. Yeah, we get bombed every once in a while.
It's not that often. It doesn't happen all the time.
How often? Like, how long have you been there for?
About 6 years.
And how many missile strikes have there been?
Oh, missiles? There have been thousands.
Thousands
of missile strikes.
Jesus. It's like four a day.
Jews do love money. So you doubled your income, and your odds of being annihilated by a missile have like gone up by the hundreds.
No, where I am, it's not so bad.
Yeah, of course.
Not so bad.
The money's good.
The missiles are coming from Gaza, which doesn't come to my area. It's far enough.
It's far enough.
Those bad old putty tats. What's wrong with you?
Hey, listen, you could be walking downstairs and somebody could hit you. It's not like, you know.
Well, yeah, it's true. You are from what part of Brooklyn were you from?
I'm not from Jersey.
Oh, okay. Well, how did Brooklyn come up?
We're talking about the deli in the film.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Gotcha. What part of Jersey were you from? Newark?
Lakewood.
Oh,
yeah.
Because I was going to say Newark, you'd probably be like, thank God. Yeah. I'm in Israel now. I feel safe.
Lakewood's pretty nice, isn't it?
Is it?
Yeah, it's Jew town.
Is it Jew town? You're very Jew centric. Are you very proud of your heritage?
I'm very proud that I'm Jewish.
How long have you been a fan of the show for?
Been listening since 2009, right when they came to NEW.
So you heard
Spaz and everything else.
But did you hear the intern David years?
Of course.
What did you think of that? I mean, we had Otto. I don't know if you remember. We had this weaselly intern, this skinny. He looked like he could have been in the Revenge of the Nerds movie. Like, right. He was the stereotypical. you know, thick Coke bottle glasses geek.
I think it was Otto who gave the best description of him as he looks exactly what an old Jew should look like.
Really?
Yeah. I'm almost positive.
He did like he did a kosher sports report. I'm sure you interacted with him.
I remember that guy.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. But he would always come on the air proud of his Jewish heritage. Opie and Anthony would ask him questions about being Jewish, and he would get everything wrong.
I would always call in and correct him.
You would.
Really?
How did you feel as that? Because, you know, there's not a lot of Jewish influence on the Opie and Anthony show.
He didn't represent us well. He really didn't know much, but typical American Jew.
Oh, yeah.
You find that to be a lot of American Jews don't really know what they're talking about?
They don't know much. Most Jews are secular. They're not really too religious. I was brought up a little bit different, so I know a little bit more.
And you like that better?
Life. I mean, I just know more
life
shit.
Life is life.
Just take it day by day. Holy shit, he is geeky looking.
Yeah, that's intern David. I don't know if you've
ever seen him before.
No. Nope.
So what time do you listen when you wake up in the morning to a replay or whatever? Do you
I listen live. You guys are on at what is it, 6 over here? By us is 1 p.m. So when I'm in the middle of work. I listen 4 hours straight, and then I get the wonderful show on now, the shit show.
Jesus,
he looks a little bit like Stephen Hawking if he was younger. Yeah.
If Stephen Hawking could walk,
yeah,
he'd look like stupid intern David.
Yeah,
intern David. Now, just to update you, Otto, he's working at the World Trade Center monument.
Oh,
like instructing families on how to find their loved ones on the thing.
Jeez,
but he refuses to acknowledge the show whatsoever. What? Like Travis, our producer, he's been down there, and he goes, David. And David ignores him like he never said a word. Opie's seen him like on the street, and David runs the other way.
Was there a bad ending?
No, he says. I mean, you've seen him. You know what's actually going on. But he thinks that him being on this show, O&A, has cost him jobs.
Oh,
like he goes to job interviews and they won't hire him, as opposed to just him being who he is costing him jobs. You know.
Because you guys depicted him as a nerd and a geek and a simp?
I guess. That's a perfect word. Simp.
Man.
Yeah, I guess because, you know, I guess our show doesn't have the greatest reputation in corporate America. But,
yeah.
I mean, David, you seem to be David from Israel now we're talking to. You seem to be a pretty, you know, a pretty heavy part of corporate world, I guess.
Yes and no.
You know.
So you went on vacation in Israel and you got a job and moved there. Now, when you take a vacation from Israel, you come.
Yeah,
to New
I come
York.
Here. I come here a few times a year.
You come back to see family.
So now
and
officially, I'm on vacation. I have a family wedding and stuff like that. So.
Oh, cool.
All your family still lives here.
I have one sister that lives there temporarily. She's like vacation instead of hanging out there, but the rest of my family's from here. Everybody's here.
Your family does a lot of vacationing. I'm finding everything happens on vacation.
I'm the only rich one. So I'm the only one that really flies back and forth.
Yeah, you're rich. Did you say I'm the
rich,
only rich one? What did you just say?
From my family, I have the most.
Oh, I see. And that's because you made the move to Mistletown.
Mistletown? Occasional.
Well, so when I said bomb attacks, and you said seldom, and I said I was assuming missile strikes counted as
missile strikes
as bomb attacks. What did you mean when you said it doesn't happen too often?
Well, it's two separate things. You have the missile attacks that are coming in from Gaza, but it mainly hits Ashdod.
And how far away from you were that?
Two and a half hour drive, 3 hour drive from this.
It's like Pittsburgh.
It's so, not that far away. Those are the missile attacks, and that depends on Hamas whenever they want to act up, when they make problems. Right now, there was just that switch where they gave up a bunch of terrorists for the soldier Gilad Shalit.
Mm-hmm.
I believe half of the soldiers that they promised to give back, they gave back. The other half they're still waiting another month or two. So Hamas wants the credit on their street that they got the rest of them freed, so it's not in their interest to make problems. As soon as they have their boys back, they're going to make more problems. The bombings are something else. The bombings are where they'll go into a cafe, they'll go into a mall with a bomb, or the last one was at the central bus station, I would say about a year ago.
Like a suicide bomber.
Either a suicide bomber or the two pussies, so they'll just go ahead and put a bag and blow it up and see what happens.
Oh, one of those see something, say something suitcases.
Oh, man.
But but because of that, the security is very, I mean, here, if a suitcase is on the street, people will see it. People may or may not call the police. By us, if you went ahead and put a suitcase on the side of the road, or you put a suitcase on the sidewalk somewhere,
mm-hmm.
everybody leaves, they call the police. Bomb squad comes in, and they bring in a robot.
How many bombs have gone off near you? How many had that
next to me? No, when I was there 11 years ago,
yeah,
I heard of a bombing, so I went down to see what it was like. The American tourist I was, I went down to see, you know, what happens. But I've never actually been anywhere.
You went down to see what was like.
to see what happens. You want to see, you know.
You blow up.
Yeah.
Well, no, it's the aftermath. It's not like there's going to be a bombing here later today. Let's go check it out. Bring our camera.
That's what it sounded like. So there was a bombing and you went to go check it out.
That was the only one time. But the security is very, very tough. I mean, my office building, the security guards, everybody's armed over there.
All these families mourning the loved ones that they lost in this bombing, and David is over. Oh, look at this! It's pretty cool.
Taking some pictures.
Don't you have any national like pride that where you want to like join the military or offer?
Look
some
at
service?
Me! You think what I could join the military?
I could fire an Uzi. You don't have to have a flat stomach to fire an Uzi into a room of Arabs.
Yeah, you have to be fit beyond that Israeli. I'm still an American. I'm just working.
You're Jewish. You're in Israel, and you're an American. They hate Americans. They hate Jews, and they hate Israelis. You have three Trifecta. Reasons to want those guys dead. Oh God, he's a wimp. no anger at all. I mean, you just—it's just a natural.
I hate them. I hate what they do. What are you gonna do?
But what am I gonna do?
Yeah, the Jews have been hated. The central of the world hatred for so long that it's just a reality that you just accept and run with it, right?
I mean, if they're gonna make problem, I would be the first one to go ahead and mow them over if somebody's trying to come after me. But so long as they're living their life, I mean, I'm not gonna be the one to say, "Hey, they're all a bunch of good guys that are all innocent. There's just a few that are bad." I think most of them are bad.
Yeah.
I think most of them are troublemakers. But I don't really run into problems. I don't really have people to come over and set up with me. If I think there's a problem and a guy comes running up to my car and tries to do something to me, I'll mow them over, no problem.
Right.
But on the other hand, if somebody else is living their life, if I don't like what they do, I don't like what their people do to me, I'm not going to just go around, you know, and killing people.
So if somebody's trying to blow you up, you'll stop them. But if somebody's trying to blow up the guy next to you, you'll just keep driving. It's not me, so.
I didn't say that. It's like if they're living their daily life and they're doing what they're doing, there's no reason for me to be carrying a gun and running around after them. If I was living in a dangerous neighborhood where I used to work, where I was surrounded by Arabs, I probably would get a gun.
If they pull up the guy right next to him, that's still going to put a crimp in his weekend. It's like they're going to go on skate. That's going to be a really exact bomb or a really shitty bomb for him to like, feel nothing.
I also love
a slight ringing.
The security is very tough. They also heavily, heavily, heavily racially profiled by us. If I'm going through a checkpoint, they'll look at me, see I'm Jewish, see the Jewish nose, let me go straight by.
Oh. They like that.
Yeah, if somebody looks, you know, two shades of mocha, is driving by, they'll pull him over, take out his ID, and if they don't like the way he looks, empty out their car, check him out.
Beautiful country.
That's the only way you could do it. If they did it here, life would be a lot better.
So what do you do? You're a suitcase salesman over there? You sell to the bombers?
Yeah.
This is perfect.
Well, I mean, as long as they don't, you know, blow the suitcase up around me, I'll sell them the suitcase. I got to make money.
Not Jewish, I'm not.
Oh, fuck.
But how about the way...
Missile strikes.
How about the way we cover what's going on with you, you know, on the news and stuff? Like, you're talking about thousands of missiles launching on you, and it doesn't seem like we hear a ton about that over here.
You don't hear a ton about it. Of course, as a Jew, I'm going to say the media doesn't like us so much, and they don't always fully report it.
I thought you ran the media.
Some of us. And the other problem is, if there's a breaking story, something that happens once, like if there was a bomb, like where there was almost a bomb here in Times Square, almost about a year ago, something like that. So it was a big story that happened here. By us, it's happening so often. I mean, by us, every single time it happens, it's in the news, you hear about it. But it doesn't always be brought over because you have shit happening all around the world. So if this is something that would happen, I mean, whenever there is a bombing by us, like when a bus gets blown up or a cafe gets blown up or something like that, it'll even be over here on the news. But the missiles, you hear about it, they mention about it, but it's just news. It's not something that once in a million years that happened. When we went into Gaza and we blew the shit out of them, then it was a big story because it's something big we did. But unfortunately, the missiles happen all the time. That's not just the biggest story.
I like that David from Israel here just told Otto that he was not in good enough shape to join the military, but he's sitting in front of us wearing a hammer strength cap. Isn't that a workout hat?
That's true. So you were saying before that the missiles always hit in one point, wouldn't it?
They don't hit one point. They keep making them bigger and better.
Right.
But it's hitting more to the south of Israel, not where I am.
What's over there? Is that where the army installments are more? Or?
Well, no, that's as far as the... Gaza's to the
that's as far as the missile will go.
That's as far as the missile will go. If they could blow us up from beginning to end from the entire country, they would.
Right.
They don't want peace. They want the entire country. They don't want, you know... They're just doing it little by little.
Yeah.
And they're going to try to break us, and so far we're still here.
What is their main beef with the Jews? They want that land. That's their holy land, they say.
It depends who you ask. They say Well, it depends. Everybody's going to go out and say they want peace. We're going to say we want peace. They're going to say they want peace. If you look hard enough, there are websites that say that if you translate their speeches when they're talking, they're actually, when they speak in Arabic, they're speaking against Israel, but when they speak in English, they speak for. I don't speak Arabic, so I can't tell you for sure what they're saying, but that's what they say. It's still propaganda. They try to do it. What I don't get is that there was a war. Well, in the beginning, we were supposed to split it with them. We were attacked. I forgot which war it was. I'm not a good history Jew. It was in 67. We were attacked by Egypt and two other countries. In 6 days, we wiped out three armies.
Right.
You started up with me. Fuck you. I chased you out of your land. I got your land. It's now mine.
Right.
Leave me the hell alone. Why should... It's like as if Mexico were to go ahead and say, hey, we want California back. We're going to stop making problems. We're going to stop bombing you until we get our land back. We took it from you. You lost. Go fuck yourself.
Yeah.
I mean, and the problem that we have is also is not with the Arabs that live in Israel. A lot of people don't know this. There is a big Israeli Arab population. We have a bunch of Arabs living in Israel. They have more freedom and rights in Israel by us than they have if they would be living in Gaza and stuff like that. There are a lot of Israeli Arabs. They get wealth, the social programs. There's social health benefits. There's no discrimination allowed if a person's Jewish or if a person's. It happens because that's the way security is, but we treat them very well. The problem that we have is the people living on the other side. We are working with the West Bank, with Mohammed Abbas, and they're trying to make peace, but Gaza won't even recognize us. They'll never work with us. So it's just a war that's going to keep on going. And no matter what they say,
It's been so long that it's like the norm. They can't seem to end it. Nobody's going to back down.
Anything's going to happen until shit really blows up over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, because it's almost like people get confused over, like, they don't even remember really what they're fighting for.
It's like
you just simply ask, what's the beef? And we have to go in. You know what I mean? It's just been going on for so long. That nobody even it's like the Wall Street thing. Like, in the beginning,
they're born into it. The Israeli children have learned how to assemble an Uzi, but as part of their junior high, grade school.
Yeah,
it's part of the norm. It's crazy.
How long after being? Because I noticed when you were talking, you were saying us, as in Israelis. How long? Is your family Israeli or is?
My family's straight up from here.
So how long were you in Israel before you started considering it your home? You know what I mean?
I don't know, 3-4 years. I was just hanging out there. I was hanging out there and then got a job and thought I was going to come back. And job got better and better. Money got better and better. So I'm still sticking around. If anybody wants to hire, I'm thinking of coming back.
You are? How come?
I can't really talk about it over here, but...
Gotcha.
The summer's pretty hot, brutally hot there.
Summer's hot there, but like now when I left there, it must have been 70 degrees. I got on the plane in a t-shirt and landed here and froze my ass off.
Yeah.
So it's actually very nice.
Just
over
like
there
Florida.
Yeah, that's where Jews like going, where it's nice.
Yeah, less missile strikes in Boca Raton.
Well, listen, I have to tell you, Otto, you've impressed me. I think that you have turned into a great interviewer.
Oh,
I'm looking forward now because it's funny that he's here because you turn on interviewer mode immediately and people are going to be able to see you interviewing people. Would you have somebody like David from Israel on the pig roast?
Hell yeah.
Like it's not giant celebrities like you were saying.
I want to know everything.
Just interesting people.
I'd rather not sit in a plane that long just to satisfy my curiosity to go to a place like that.
Yeah.
That's the main reason I don't go, overseas and shit. I can't stand a plane ride that's over 7 hours long.
You don't sleep on planes?
No, I get very ill. That recirculated air.
Yeah, yeah.
I can't stand flying that. It really feels... Yeah. Yeah. Shitty movies. How long is the flight to Israel?
Flight going there is about 10. Coming back, it's about 11 hours.
From Kennedy? You go from Kennedy?
Kennedy or Newark.
Oh, okay.
And how often did you say you make the trip?
2, 3, 4 times a year, depending on work and depending on family, but...
It's a long flight. Well... Dave, I'm glad that you represent us all that we were just talking about when Jim was in here about not knowing where people are from. Right, and you're listening all the way in Israel. It's a cool thing.
That's great.
And you'll be able to watch pigroast.tv too, because that's the beauty of the internet now, that everything is worldwide. It's not a matter of figuring out if you get it on your TV or whatever. It's all over the place.
It's amazing. Some guy from Scotland just got in touch with me. And I sent him he wanted a DVD and
But Trish was communicating, and Trish sent him a DVD, and I wanted to find out how he knew about me. You know, just you know, if you're gonna give a guy a DVD, just say, how did you find? How the hell does a guy in Scotland know who the fuck I am? I never played over there.
Yeah,
you know, maybe I guess it was from the show prop, most likely. Right?
Maybe, and yeah. I know the YouTube is crazy now. I know a lot of people who just look up O&A clips on YouTube. Like, they don't have radios, they don't listen to the show, they just found different O&A clips on YouTube, and everything's up there now. But it's pigroast.tv, and we've played the preview clip on the air before, but that's what's up on the website right now, and it's definitely a sign of things to come. Have you, David, have you seen the preview clip yet?
I didn't see the clip. No, I heard you talking about it. I'll check it out on Tuesday next week.
You got to check it out, because it's not just like a typical talk show, because it's more than a podcast. It's not a podcast. It's a real, like Otto was saying, it was filmed on a set lights, you know, he's at a desk. It's like a takeoff on a talk show / old school variety show, right?
Exactly. Yeah, we have recurring characters. We did some location stuff. We did that Comic-Con thing, whatever that's called. I was down there for that.
Oh yeah, Jim and me saw you there at Comic Con. Yeah, we did
that shit. We did a sketch on To Catch a Predator, so that was shot somewhere else, another location. Next season, if we have a next season, we're gonna try and do a lot of remotes. Like, I want to interview Lewis Black on his bus.
Yeah,
you know, I think he'd be more comfortable there.
I was gonna ask
the studio.
Yeah, I was gonna ask if you do that for people like Pat Cooper. If you would just go and take a camera down to Friars Club.
Why not? I think it'd be great.
Interview him there. How nice is it to just be able to do it and not have to worry about like networks and script supervisors and all this and that?
Yeah, so far there's nobody interfering with anything we said. You know. Yeah.
I guess it'd be nice to have a little bit of interference because you want advertisers and stuff eventually, right? How are you thinking about, like, what's the next step for this? If this is successful, do you bring in advertisers? Do you try to sell it to somebody?
That's all the producer's job is to raise, he's thinking liquor companies, cigarettes, you know, condoms, you know. What he was saying to me when he pitched the show is that I got to reach a younger audience because, you know, my average fan is now either married with kids and doesn't go out anymore.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I have to, and that the younger, the people that are on the internet would love my shit. They just don't know who I am.
Yeah.
So we want to get those people to know who I am and stuff.
And is the only way to see the show on pigroast.tv, or are you going to have it on YouTube as well? Or you don't know?
Probably both, eventually, yeah. We'll probably put the highlights on there. Well, yeah.
Otto will be tweeting it out and everything. If you're looking for sponsors and people who want to talk to young people, you know who I would get?
Yeah.
Is I Hate Steven Singer. I don't know if you know about I Hate Steven Singer. Yeah. But he's
the silver guy, right?
That's right. He's selling Argentium now. A lot of people don't know what Argentium is. It's Steven Singer's new super silver collection. That's right. Steven Singer's brand new collection of silver is made from Argentium, the king of all silver metals. Like, you're about to be the king of the internet variety show. Steven Singer is the king of silver. The brand new collection starts at $149, which is, I mean, you know, for jewelry, for silver, it's nothing. It's more pure than sterling silver. It's brighter than platinum, white gold, and sterling. Low maintenance, tarnish resistant, and Argentium is responsible and ethical because it's produced using only recycled silver. If you want to check it out, you don't have to get off your couch. You don't have to do anything. You just pick up your phone and you call 1-888-I-HATE-STEVEN-SINGER. They'll tell you about it. You can look at it at ihatestevensinger.com. They ship for free. They'll give you a money-back guarantee. Visit him in person if you can. He's in Philadelphia. David from Israel, while you're in town going on, you know, the O&A tour, I would say go down to Philly. He's on the other corner of 8th and Walnut. He's got a beautiful store. I'm there when I need jewelry because he hooks me up, and I'm sure he'd hook you up too. Just tell him who you are and tell him I sent you. That's I Hate Steven Singer or ihatestevensinger.com for all your Argentium and other jewelry needs. So, I mean, it may be a good idea for you is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah, I'll be a lazy Jew and go on the internet.
Yeah, well, you could check him out on the internet too. Where's Travis? Because I want to talk about what we were talking about earlier. You know, you talk about variety shows. We're doing this show at the Hard Rock tomorrow morning.
Yeah, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, it's going to be fun. It's at 8 a.m. There's still room for people. So we had a RSVP list. That got completely filled up. But we're letting, like, another 400 people in on a first-come, first-served basis.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to check out this show,
definitely come, come like 7:30, I guess, tomorrow at the Hard Rock in Times Square and check it out, because we're gonna be doing the mash. We're gonna do a mashed potato eating contest, and that's gonna be going on the whole thing. Somebody's gonna we're gonna have 10 pounds of mashed potatoes for each person.
Ouch.
Wow. And whoever eats the most within the 2 hours or however long the show is going to get $500.
Pat from Moonaki going to be part of it?
That's the thing. He's not coming.
He's not coming.
He's got something going on. I don't know
is
why.
Is he
going
to get diabetes the fastest contest?
No, I don't think so. But he's not coming, so that leaves a lot of room open for people, because otherwise you're not going to want to enter, because 500 is going to Pat. He's a professional. David, are you going to the Hard Rock tomorrow?
Tomorrow, yeah.
Maybe you'll be one of the contestants.
I just found out I have diabetes, so no.
You just found out?
About a month ago.
Pat and the Nathans every year.
Yeah.
It's hard to get into that.
It is.
To qualify.
You have to go through qualifiers and everything.
You have to win a bunch of shit before you get to the Nathan's point, right?
Yeah. I mean, I know people who have tried to get on to the, you know, to the official game, and they can't make it. Pat makes it, has made it the last few years.
Mm-hmm.
He hasn't won one yet, but he will.
No.
I mean, he's going to get there. We're also doing, I think we're going to do listener karaoke.
Those fat guys never win. It's those little weird guys.
Have you seen the guy, like Kobayashi?
Kobayashi, like, has this weird thing he does with his body.
Yeah.
He shifts his organs around.
He's jacked now, though. He's got muscles.
Yeah.
And he's skinny. He's got zero body fat.
Yeah.
But he eats like 47 hot dogs in a sitting.
Yeah.
It's the craziest thing in the world.
It's incredible.
But
what's
we're all,
that guy, his name, Chestnut, who's one
Joey
of the
Chestnuts?
Friends? Yeah.
Yeah, he like shoves the, like the hot dogs into his cheeks or something.
How many are you doing? What's the time they do it in?
For the hot dog contest
12,
or for the Hard Rock?
10 or 12 minutes. Oh,
the Nathans.
Oh, the Nate. Yeah, I think it's like 12 minutes or something. Yeah.
For how many does the winner do? How many do they do?
I think close to 50.
Holy
shit. I think Joey Chestnut got in the upper 40s this year.
They're up to that.
I mean, Pat, like Pat from Moonaki, I think he usually does in the 20s, like the, you know, the high 20s, like 26, 27, 28. Which is ridiculous for 12 minutes.
I thought he was doing it just to get his name out there. Like, I figured he would quit after 10, but you have to really look like you're trying, right?
Oh, yeah.
He just go there for a free meal.
He makes an effort. Yeah. For a free meal. He just loves hot dogs.
Sam, if they did a Snickers contest, you'd probably win?
No, I don't like Snickers.
Or chocolate in general?
I don't know. No. I couldn't eat. I mean, I eat chicken a lot. I don't eat a lot of chocolate.
All right. I thought there was... Wasn't there a contest something a while back, like about a year ago, where they had you eat as much chocolate as possible?
No. That's right, though. That's what we're going to be doing tomorrow. One of the interns...
Oh, it was one of the interns?
Yeah, I think it was like on Halloween, or the day after Halloween, we ended up with like a giant thing of chocolate bars.
Correct.
Oh. And yeah, we just had intern Craig sit down for like 3 hours and just stuff his fat face with chocolate. Fuck.
I think at 80-something, he ended up puking all over.
Yeah, and then he just puked all over. And the thing tomorrow is if you puke, you can puke, but you're out of the contest.
Oh.
So you can't just regurgitate, like, you know, we've had other eating contests where people just shove a finger down their throat and then they keep going because they empty out their stuff. It's horrible. We had one thing
eggnog?
Where,
Never mind. Was it eggnog?
Yeah. We had an eggnog contest where we had a guy puke and then drink the puke that he just puked out. I mean, I'm sure we couldn't do that anymore because now there are actually bosses paying attention.
Yeah.
But back then it was like, it's insane.
Yeah.
We're also doing listener karaoke. I don't know how that's going to work, but I think we got a karaoke thing. Travis, if you're there, I don't know if we should show the costumes because we have
Koshwa?
Outfits.
Yeah.
Because the big event for tomorrow is the skit. We're doing the first Thanksgiving pageant skit, whatever you want to call it, like you do in first grade. Except we're using people from the show. We're going to have like Ant and Starker Patty are going to be pilgrims. And Jim is gonna do Jim's gonna do Chip, and him and Bobo and Voss are gonna be Indians. And then E-Rock, you found out today that you were cast.
Yes, I did.
As the turkey.
I love how you act so fucking surprised.
He's gonna be the turkey.
Yeah, E-Rock's gonna get to be the turkey. We have a turkey outfit back there and everything.
That's great.
What do you mean you love how I act so surprised?
Because you play off like, oh, I thought somebody would have told you by now. You wrote the damn thing.
He's the closest looking to a turkey.
Whoa. you're okay playing the turkey though, right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Are you looking forward to it?
I don't know what the turkey is doing in this performance, but. I guess so far I'm okay.
I don't know if we should I don't think we should show you the script before you go on there.
Well, the turkey doesn't have lines.
Oh, yes, it does.
It The turkey's talking?
Oh, yeah. We wrote lines for the turkey.
Okay.
We wrote lines for everybody. We don't want anybody to feel left out. You can't just sit there going gobble, gobble.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But you are kind of... What's more important on the first Thanksgiving than the turkey? You know?
I have no idea.
We waited. Can I tell you the truth, E-Rock?
Yeah.
We waited. We were talking about this in the office a couple days ago, and we waited to tell you on the air because we thought that you would not be willing to play the turkey unless Opie and Anthony specifically on the air said E-Rock's playing the turkey, and then they would push you into it.
Well, I don't think the turkey is really that bad.
Well, I guess... What could be worse in the skit than the turkey?
Some of the other people's costumes.
Oh, well, we do have a special costume plan.
He's like Bobby Bacala with the Santa suit and fucking big pussy. Shyness is a curse.
Fuck you, Santa.
We have a special... Have you met Bobo, Otto?
Yeah.
Yeah, we have a costume planned out for him.
Oh, good.
He's going to be... we're going to try to make sure he wears something revealing. Something for the girls. You know?
Yeah? Nice.
Because, you know, they all like to see Bobo, Skimpy. And Roland... Roland's going to
Roland
be
have a costume, too?
I don't think we have... Maybe we'll put him... Maybe the narrator should also be
dressed... like a pilgrim,
A pilgrim. Roland, do you think the narrator... Because you're going to be in the skit. Mm-hmm. You're the narrator. Is this something... You're not...
Did Roland find out on the air, too?
Did anybody tell you ahead of time? It's okay if they did. Don't say it for
all
the...
All he said is we have something for you.
Like, oh, okay.
What about Club Soda Kenny?
Club Soda Kenny is going to be acting as security.
Oh.
And all I'll say is that I did write something in for a security guard, but I don't want to say more than that because I don't want to spoil it for the parties involved specifically, as well as the audience.
He's funny as an Indian.
I know. Club Soda Kenny be funny as anything, though. He's awesome.
Yeah.
And the narrator's neutral.
Yes, the narrator is neutral. But are you worried? Because you're not known for your public speaking abilities.
Nor are my reading skills. That's correct, sir.
Are you worried at all? Standing in front of the crowd? The last Hard Rock event we did, it was staff stand-up. And Roland did well. He did get some help with his jokes, but I think that's okay.
Oh, yeah.
You know, a first-time stand-up's going to get help with his jokes. It was more your stage presence that I think impressed people. You feeling confident about this one?
If people piss me off, I just focus my rage and I'll ad lib a lot in the script.
You just take shots at people?
Yeah, adding rape, death.
No, Roland.
Hoping that you'll be fucked in the mouth.
Me?
No, I say people who piss me off, bad things will be added on.
Well, how
like
people?
Paterno jokes.
This I gotta see.
Paterno jokes?
Yes.
Well, first of all,
Sandusky jokes.
Yeah, you should realize, as Eric just.
I know, that's why I like that.
It's not.
People get more angry with Paterno.
Because it's not Paterno.
Exactly.
Are you...
if people make me happy, I'll just stick to the script.
Yeah, has anybody showed you the script?
Travis handed me a script.
But you didn't read it?
No, because I know that by the time I get to Hard Rock, I'll be like, totally different.
Yeah, we changed some stuff. Here's the new script.
And then I'm like, okay, I'll memorize it. Then I'm going to spend time. I'm like, fuck it. I'm going to spend no time.
Are you glad that you're the narrator instead of something else?
Who knows what's going
to
happen?
At least you don't have to, like, act.
You think these guys are going
to
act?
Well, they're supposed to. Have you seen Voss when he acts? Did you see when we had Chaz Palminteri on O&A?
No.
And we had Voss and Chaz Palminteri do a scene from A Bronx Tale.
Oh, shit, really?
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's on YouTube or something. Do we have Bronx Tale production?
Was that great?
We have the produced piece. Let me see if I have just the script without the produced stuff on it.
Yeah, see if it's not too long, we'll play it for
Otto. I love Chaz. He's awesome.
Yeah, it was so great.
Yeah,
it was the second time he was on.
Wow.
And he was just like, he picked it up. Obviously, it's his thing. But, I mean, he was out of the movie good.
Yeah.
And Voss was just horrendous.
was he playing the kid?
I think so.
The little beans?
Yeah. He was the worst actor that you could imagine. E-Rock's looking for the clip because you got to hear it.
That's hysterical.
Were you listening to that show, David? Heard?
When Voss speaks like this?
Yes.
Then yes, I heard it.
What do you think of Voss's tattoos? He's a Jewish man. Jews usually say tattoos are bad, but he put the Star of David on his arm.
Still not supposed to, but he has it. Shit happens.
That's it. Now, what are you going to do as long as he's making money?
Simple. Why make it complicated?
That's good. For sure. And when you go to Israel, shit happens.
Shit happens. Yeah. Deal with it.
I found that it's 1 minute for the dry, and then the produced is like a minute 10.
I guess go with the produced.
The produced one?
It's probably a little funnier. Yeah.
Okay.
Here it is, Otto. This is Voss and Chaz Palminteri together.
Ooh.
Robert De Niro.
It's not what you say, it's what he sees.
In his directorial debut.
We can't accept that.
Starring Chaz Palminteri.
I didn't give it to you, I gave it to your son.
And Rich Voss.
Louie, Beans, I want my money.
A Bronx Tale.
Beans, you can't dodge me forever.
Come on, what are you doing about? What are you yelling about, huh?
John, I got a problem with this guy over here, Louis Beans. This guy owes me 20, and it's been 2 weeks now, and every time he sees me, he keeps dodging me, John. Should I crack him one or what?
The struggle of an idiotic Jewish comedian stammering his way through a few lines of film dialogue with a genuine Hollywood actor.
Listen, see, sometimes violence is not the answer. Is he a good friend of yours or not?
Nah, John, I don't even like him.
Well, there's your answer right there. Look at it this way. It costs you $20 to get rid of him. He's never going to ask you for money again. He's never going to bother you again. He's out of your life for $20. Come on, you got up cheap.
You're right, John. You're always right.
A Bronx Tale.
How do you know the right answer all the time, Johnny?
Well, I try to keep my eyes and ears open all the time. And I read.
You read?
Yeah, I read. Come on. Come on, let's go to Mario's next door and get something.
That's great.
That was Hollywood Rich Voss.
That was great. An idiotic Jew comedian.
You see him in person, he is funny.
Voss is hilarious on stage. Yeah. I'm just saying he's not the caliber actor that Chaz Palminteri is.
No, funny.
It's great. Who's back in the office right now? Somebody just run up with the turkey costume. I would like Eric.
I think they took you to the Hard Rock.
Oh, it's already there?
Yeah, I think they're Death of Travis. Everybody went to the Hard Rock.
Where is Danny saying it's gone? Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, the turkey costume's already gone. I would have loved for you to see it and get your final approval on it, Eric.
Did you see it?
Yes, of course I did.
Mm-hmm. I saw it, too.
I'm sure my approval would really weigh heavy as far as what the costume's going
to
be.
That's why I wanted to show it to you.
It's almost like a grown man's baby turkey costume.
It is. What do you think?
A what?
Grown man's baby turkey costume?
Yeah.
Like a little baby would wear it?
Yeah.
What do you think of... you didn't read Eric's part of the script either?
I didn't see his name on my script. I think I got a different script that like they think I'm a memorized, so that's why I just tossed it.
Yeah, you don't have to memorize it.
Are we going to be able to see this on YouTube when it's done, or should have to be there live to see it?
We should try to film it.
Yeah,
I'm sure we can get somebody to video it.
Definitely video and put it on YouTube.
Yeah, it's going to be funny. I mean, you definitely want to see it in person if you can. It's free, and it's a show.
Yeah.
We're going to do the after show from the Hard Rock, too, whatever time. Oh, and they have till 11, whatever time they don't use. We're going to take it over, and I'll do the after show with all of you people.
And the big celebrity at the Hard Rock and was going to be an Indian, but he couldn't make it.
Who?
Duchovny.
David, you were trying to get David Duchovny to be an Indian?
He was in, but something came up for production. But he'll be back in January.
That would have been great.
Yeah, David, he was in for it. He's like, all right.
Wow, a real actor.
Instead, we got Bobo.
We got Bobo instead.
This is a real deal. Like, we actually have a production budget on this. Wow. We have real outfits. We have, Jim is going to do Chip as an Indian.
Well, Opie's not doing anything?
Opie.
I heard you say Anthony, but...
Yeah, Opie and Bob Kelly are going to be there kind of off to the side, commenting on it for the radio audience.
Foley work.
Doing some Foley work, stuff like that, making sure everybody making sure it translates to radio, because it can be a very visual thing. Like, we're concentrating on making sure that the fans at the Hard Rock get a good show.
Yeah.
So Opie's got to be there, making sure that the people, people listening at home.
Paul should be a pilgrim.
Are you going to be at the Hard Rock tomorrow,
yeah,
Paul?
Yeah, I'll be there.
He should be a pilgrim. There's an extra outfit.
Well, no, we were talking about the extra pilgrim outfit because we were going to have like Pat from Unaki and Big A in the skit too, but Pat, one of the first O&A shows that neither Pat from Unaki or Big A will be able to be at. Big A's a big part of the pig roast.
Yeah. He just stopped in one time and we decided to use him and he just fit right in. You can insert him into anything.
And it works.
Is there going to be any violence in this Indian and pilgrim story? Or no?
There'll be some violence.
Tomahawk chops. And
I'll just say there'll be some violence.
That's true.
We definitely wrote in.
Blood.
Yeah. We wrote in some. Huh?
We can do this extra costume.
You getting nervous? Sam, you didn't finish what you were going to say. We were thinking that maybe the narrator should be a pilgrim.
Then I'll be taking the pilgrim side of like sharing all the Indians for
the casinos. I think we have an extra Indian costume too, so maybe you are a pilgrim who has Indian pants on.
Or a costume change in the middle?
It's not a bad idea, Paul.
Like Diana Ross?
Paul, you're going to be careful. You're about to piss Roland off, and then he'll wish rapes and murders on you.
And, yeah, I go, and the baker got raped.
I don't think anybody's going to piss you off, Roland. We didn't write anything in the script that's negative about the, what's it called, the narrator.
I know, but setting up people.
Yeah. Yeah. Humble narrator.
Conveniently, I'm looking at the script that was sent. A lot of things left off that script there.
The one for you?
A lot left off. It's only like 3 pages. I got like 1 page or two.
Yeah.
It's a lot left off.
Do you have any lines on the script that was sent to you, Eric?
No.
That's weird. Unless it's something in the tech. Maybe there's a virus going around or something.
You guys are fucking doing the J.J. Abrams where you get the fake script.
Exactly.
And then you go on set and go, oh, well, here's a real script.
Well, we don't want any leaks right now.
I see lines for the narrator, for Patty.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's a bunch of other lines that have no names assigned to them.
Yeah, I think you got a very rough draft. Somebody on feedback is asking for us to get a mesh thong for Bobo. Look, I don't want to give away too much, but the Native Americans wore loincloths. And that's all I'll say.
And also they were drunks and they have casinos.
Well, that came later. Roland.
Dude, were there casinos built for the first Thanksgiving?
With that logic, we should give them a blanket with, like, disease on it.
Yeah. Oh, anthrax for the Hot Rocks?
Smallpox. Smallpox. Oh, I'm sorry. Let's not get crazy.
Yeah, smallpox.
Or just pass down the corner. I'll just start drinking like an Indian.
What? Can we dress him up after the show as an Indian and just put him on the corner?
I don't see why not. You'll be
sit
drunk.
Down in the corner drunk.
Fuck it, I'll be an Indian.
You'll be drunk by that point anyway.
I just start screaming at you guys.
I don't know if you
noticed. You brought me down.
About Roland, but he's a complete lush.
Is he?
Like, so is Bobo.
Yeah.
He could hang out all day.
Yeah, but Bobo, you get 2 beers in him and he's gone. Roland,
hysterical?
Oh. Roland, I mean, to say he drinks to excess would be a severe understatement. Roland,
he's got some legs. He can drink for a while.
Yeah, Roland, because he's like, he has to, you know, rub elbows with show business people. So he's got to be able to handle his liquor. Like, if they're like, Roland, let's go out drinking. Like, he's got to be able to hang with the SNL crew and do all this stuff. And, I mean, obviously, you've learned well, Roland.
I learned. I could do, like, 20 drinks. I'd be like, I'm okay.
Is this script finalized? Like, is it locked or can we make some amendments to it?
We can make amendments up until, yeah, why?
Because I have an idea I'd like to add to it for the Indians.
For the Indians?
Yeah.
All right. Well, I mean, because there were some suggestions. Actually, a couple of the hosts saw the script, and there were some suggestions. Even more lines are going to be added for the turkey, as a matter of fact. So congratulations, Eric. Hopefully, you know, hopefully you get some real exposure out of this and let this be the launching pad into the next big thing for you.
His new acting career.
Yeah.
I would love if this bullshit got me noticed somewhere, and I got a job, and I can leave.
Yeah,
we can Rob Cross be a pilgrim?
Thank God it won't. Huh?
Can Rob Cross be a pilgrim?
No, we don't have any room for more pilgrims right now.
No, you can just walk around the room.
You just want him in the skit.
Yeah.
You just take shots at Rob Cross is our boss.
Rob wants an acting career out of this fucking turkey bit. I love it.
Yeah, he thinks it's really going to...
There's no more Carvel maybe chain. The turkey. That's the only thing I can think of.
Maybe the turkey fucking shows turkey. Up on the pig roast.
Yeah. I don't know, some kind of agent. Well, if you want to see the Pig Roast, November 22nd is when it debuts, correct?
Yeah, man, thanks.
It's going to be on pigroast.tv. And, I mean, around here, we've been hearing about this forever, so we're all pumped for it. And how often are new episodes going to be up?
I think every week, I'm pretty sure.
That's what you're probably going to do?
Ideally, yeah. It would go once a week, yeah.
It's going to be good. How long is it?
It's all each show is 30 minutes. And then there are some shows that we might have a lot of like to see the complete interview, go to this site or whatever.
Oh, I got you.
That kind of shit.
So like extra features like that.
Yeah, there was a guy that Jimmy McMullen.
McMillan. Yeah. The Rents.
We had him on. He's the only guest we had twice. In 10
he rules.
He's great. He's just awesome. Great. Just wind him up and he goes.
We'll definitely make sure you check that out. Come out to the Hard Rock tomorrow. It's in Times Square. We'll be there starting at 8, so get there a little before, and there'll be room for all of you. After Opie and Anthony Live has been brought to you, as it always is, by Trojan Bearskin Condoms. Trojan, America's number one most trusted condom brand. Thanks for stopping by, David, from Israel.
One more thing. Anybody looking to hire a soft switch engineer? At Dovid, D-O-V-I-D on Twitter. I'm looking.
Hit him up on Twitter.
Cool.
Ron and Fez are coming up next. Thanks again, Otto. Pigroast.tv.
Thank you.
You got it. We'll see you tomorrow live from the Hard Rock.
Opie and Anthony show is now over. For real this time.